Hi everyone and welcome back. So we can try a few more examples about writing the custom hooks. So here in the previous example we were actually doing the use axios. Similarly, we can actually change this to another hook like use fetch, which is a native fetch API, right? So we can use the same code. What we need is we will be just passing two things, URL and options. In the fetch, no, not like all these options which I need for the axios, URL and options. And here in the fetch data, it is same thing like I will be making a async call in the try catch. So instead of doing this, I will be try catch finally. So here I will be getting const response equal to await. And here I will be using fetch API and passing the URL comma options, and we'll wait for the JSON to come. So I will just do await response.json. Once I return the response, I will just do a set response. So here we have the set response to actually set the value what we have received from the API. Here I'm setting JSON. And set loading is equal to false. Set is loading now will be set to false. And finally, if everything goes fine, here we are already setting error, set is loading false. And set response we just need to do as a null. Okay, if we got an error. Now what dependency we need to have is dependency can be empty because it's a one-time call, and then you can pass the URL and options also if URL is getting changed, but in a one single lifecycle call URL will not change. And finally we will be returning response error and is loading, right? Same thing we are doing with the fetch APIs, whatever we have done with the axios. Now this use fetch can be used in our application same as the use axios. Here you need URL and options. Options has all the other arguments. I will just pass the empty object, which has the method name, any header information and all. And we are actually getting the is loading error, all these arguments which we are passing. Okay. This is how same can be converted to this. Now we are just checking response not equal to null, set data, you can do all these things in your component which you are writing. Other hooks we can talk about is these, like use splash screen. This is like I got this image from a blog, but what it is doing is it is just getting one image from some API call where you need to pass client ID, query, secret ID. It's like a private image, but you have to get it on the UI. Right, so you are doing a use effect, you are actually passing secret and query. We have the URL, so use effect is doing the same async and asynchronous operation. Initially it will set the loading state to true. Once it will do await onto that axios call. If you get the response, set loading false, add image to that result, and then return the images error and loading state. So whenever you do the asynchronous operation through these hooks, custom hooks, return the error, loading state and the actual data. So that while consuming it, I will come to know if response is null means we got an error message. So okay, let's show the error message. Okay, so these are the basic different examples. In coming examples or coming demo, practical React.js application, we will be using the React lifecycle hooks, lifecycle methods, these React hooks, context APIs everywhere. So if you follow the whole series, you will be good enough to be call yourself as an expert in React.js. Okay, thanks everyone. Thanks for watching. If you have any feedback, please add that in the comment. If you like my videos, then please subscribe my channel. And if you have any feedback, comment, if you want me to cover a particular training course, just add that in the comment. Thanks everyone.